Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Welcome to my channel if you're new. Today I'm gonna be doing a more chill sit down video. I'm gonna be doing a get ready with me and also just chit chatting about everything that's been going on in my life. I've been wanting to do this video for a while now and I thought today would be the perfect time because there's so many life updates I need to give you and I also just wanna have a girl chat. I feel like there's been so many things going on in my mind that I wanna share with you and I like to film my videos as if I'm talking to a friend on FaceTime, so I hope that's how it feels like to you. So we're just gonna have a catch-up FaceTime call while I get ready, and I'm gonna shut my mouth and start doing my makeup. Well, I'm technically not gonna shut my mouth. I'm gonna stop talking for this intro. So anyways, let's just get into the makeup and let's not shut our mouth, but keep talking. Okay. Let's get into the makeup. I have nowhere to be or no reason to be doing my makeup other than this video and just for fun. I usually film get ready with me's and stuff like that when I'm actually going somewhere or I need somewhere to be, but it's probably better that I film this video with, you know, nowhere to be, no plans because I won't be in a rush. I think the last get ready with me I filmed, let's see, I think it was for class. I was doing it in, I think, my last vlog and I was late. I literally saved extra time for filming, but you know, I'm a blabbermouth. Now I have nowhere to be, no plans. Today is actually a packing day, and I was debating even filming this video because I have nowhere to be to do my makeup, but there's so many things going on in my life that I've been meaning to update you all on, so I thought the best way to do it is a get ready with me. My hair is out of my face, and let's do a little bit of makeup. I do have some products I've been wanting to use. I've been sticking to the same products. But I have some older products I kind of want to experiment with, so I think today is the perfect time to do that. One of those products is the Say Glowy, what is this? The Glowy Super Gel and Star Glow. This isn't a full makeup routine. I want to do one of those eventually. I've never tried this. I've had it for a while, so we'll see how it works. Sometimes products like this can just make my skin a lot more oily than actually, you know, glowy. But I have a list on my phone of everything. Okay, if I could see the mirror. I have a list of all of these topics that I want to dive into in this video. Something I really like to do in my videos is share advice that has been applicable to my life and advice that I need to hear. If I can just resonate with one person out there or help one person going through something, that is a job well done for me. Hoping that the advice that I share in this video and just different things that I've gone through that I'm going to talk about can be helpful for you and make you feel less alone. Before we get into all of that, I'm gonna talk about some life updates, the main reason why I'm filming this video. The first life update that I've been wanting to share with you guys, I think I've alluded to it a few times, is some trips that I'll be going on. The video after this is a pack with me for so said trip, and today is Friday, and on Monday I leave on a very exciting trip. I am gonna be going back to Europe. I was just in Europe last month in Italy, which I'm so blessed and grateful for that trip. I shared all of my travels and stuff from Italy. We are going to Dublin, Ireland, Zurich, Switzerland, and I was gonna say the wrong place, London, England. I am so excited. I have been meaning to share this with you all for quite some time. I just wanted to wait till right beforehand, till the last minute. What a surprise. My sister and I are gonna be going to Europe for 2 weeks. We're gonna go to 3 different countries. I've never been to these places. I've only been to the London airport, but other than that, these are 3 new countries for us, and we are so freaking excited. Last year around this time was the first time that I ever traveled outside of the US. I went to Copenhagen and Stockholm. It was just a life-changing experience. It was a life-changing trip for me. There was still so many things that I learned on that trip, and I'm really hoping to kick up my travel and go visit different places and different cultures and just to continue to do that throughout my early 20s and into my adult years. I love traveling and there's so many places I want to go, but I'm specifically excited for this trip because London is a place I have romanticized in my head so much, and I've always wanted to study abroad there, live there. I've never even been there, and so this trip will really show me what London is all about. We're going to be in London for a majority of the trip, so we will be in Dublin for a few days and then then in Zurich for a few days, and then we will be in London for a whole week. There's gonna be so much content. As I said before, today is Friday. I leave on Monday, but I leave out of Arizona. I left out of Arizona when I went to Italy because my sister lives in Arizona. We are gonna be driving out to Arizona tomorrow, Saturday, and then leaving on Monday. So today is my only day to get everything ready, get my content ready, get some YouTube videos up and published. I have been really adamant on filming and just been really on it and consistent with my posting because the YouTube algorithm sucks, y'all. I don't even think you understand. YouTube algorithm sucks so much, and I feel like it's already hard enough to get my videos out there. I would love for more people to watch my content. I try to be as consistent as possible so that way YouTube picks up on it and, you know, she starts doing her thing promoting my videos. That is why I'm trying really hard to get all my videos ready so that way I can go on my trip and just be stress-free about all of that. The other thing I have been waiting to share with you all, I'm so excited about this, is this summer I will not be living in my college town. I will not be living in my hometown. I will be moving to Los Angeles and I will be interning in LA this summer. Yep, I said it. I cannot believe that that is coming out of my mouth. If you were to tell me last year that I would be moving to LA this summer and doing a dream internship, I probably would have sobbed my eyes out, but I would not have believed you. Last summer, I got my first internship ever. It was unpaid. It was with a talent agency, which I didn't really know if that's what I wanted to do. I never thought that I would work my way up to a year later having a in-person paid internship. I'm gonna be interning at a film company this summer, doing public relations and doing publicity. Again, this is like a dream of mine, and I just can't believe this is happening. I have done this all on my own. I have built up my resume, my networking, and I could not be more proud of myself. As cringe as that is, I genuinely am so proud of how hard I've worked. And with that, I'm also doing this really cool program with the Academy, as in the Academy of Motion Picture, like the Academy Awards. I'm gonna be doing a program called Academy Gold Rising. I can't wait to share it with all of you guys and just take you along this journey of doing my internship this summer, being in the Academy program, and just seeing where that takes me and connecting with people in the film industry, learning more about the industry as a whole and getting that experience. It's really gonna impact my content, obviously. There's gonna be LA content. I'm gonna be an LA girl. I cannot wait to explore more of LA and just like live there because I've always wanted to do that. Now I kind of want to get into just some more things that have been going on in my life. I did move out of my college house, and that was a bit chaotic, a bit hectic, I will not lie. We did it, we're in my house in San Diego. Everything is kind of cutting it close from my trip to moving and stuff. You gotta do what you gotta do. It is what it is, but I just need to make it through, push it through, and then I'll be in LA enjoying the summer. I think one of the best lessons that I've learned for myself is I am on my own life path. Everyone is on their own life path, and there's no race for any of it. There's no race to do this internship, do this job, to graduate college. I think that there's just been this big stigma of graduating at this age and taking this much time in school. Not enough people talk about gap years and doing this and doing that. And I really wish that was talked about more because not only do more people need to hear that, I feel like it just feeds more into the track that society has for us and the path that people are supposed to take. And for me, taking a gap year and a half, I'm not gonna be probably graduating on time as my peers who I graduated high school with. It really made me come to terms with me being on my own path and taking life at my own pace. And if you're out there and you're on the same page and you are just figuring out still what you wanna do, it's so normal to be 21, 22, having no idea what you wanna do with your life. Girl, I have been there. I have been there with not knowing what I want to do. I still don't know what I want to do, if I'm being so honest. I have a good grip of what I want to do, but I don't know if that's specifically what I'm going to love doing in 3-4 years even. The piece of advice I want to share is these feelings won't last forever and it'll pass. I wish I could tell myself this in so many different situations I've been in my life. And obviously there are so many circumstances where, you know, things happen and life happens and life sucks, but if there's there's different feelings you're going through, and just like those feelings won't last forever. I really hope that can help you. Also, just taking things one at a time. It's so overwhelming to fix this, this, and this, figure out this, this, and this. It can just be such a straining process. Just focusing on one thing. Rome wasn't built in a day, what can I say? Just focusing on one thing can really be helpful, and taking it step by step. I know that's just like super cliche, but I feel like there can be so many things going on in your life you need to want to fix, you maybe need to change, but doing it all at once is just so overwhelming. And I hope that whatever you're enduring, you're going through, just taking it one step at a time can just be really helpful. On a more positive note, let's talk about being your own best friend and just going for it. I have really applied that in my life, being my own best friend. I lived on my own this semester. I'm gonna be living technically not on my own, but kind of on my own this summer. I've been trying to really focus on being my own best friend and feeding in to myself, growing who I am as a person, if that makes sense. I feel like it's so easy to get caught up in hanging out with a bunch of people and expanding your circle, but having a balance of also being content with being alone, being with yourself, because becoming your own best friend is something I wish I did earlier in my life. I still kind of struggle with it, but just being content with being alone and being happy with who you are as a person will not only attract good people into your life, but you will just automatically feel so much better about yourself. Just nurturing your relationship with yourself can be so beneficial to your mental health and also to the people around you, because being negative to yourself, especially both mentally and physically, will get you nowhere. I'm not kidding, y'all. Positivity is key. I feel like that's so cliche, maybe annoying, but you know, it is the truth. And the last thing I want to mention is just go for it. Just go for it. That is my motto this summer when it comes to content creation, when it comes to friends, when it comes to putting myself out there. Just go for it. I feel like for too long I have thought about what other people think about me, what other people say about me, and it's really held me back from pursuing social media specifically, but also just exploring who I am as a person, maybe fashion-wise or just expressing myself. I've always thought of what others will think about me. I know so many people out there have been wanting to become TikTokers and actually have a TikTok account, but they're embarrassed or they think other people are gonna judge them. And who cares? Who cares? You are not gonna be 80 years old and these people are still gonna be in your life. Protect your peace. That is another one of my biggest pieces of advice. Surround yourself with people who uplift you, who don't bring you down. If you wanna start making videos on YouTube or start a TikTok account, just go for it and don't care what anyone else thinks, because you never know what it will bring you. I know one of my favorite TikTokers, Hallie Kate, she literally just bought a house and she's an apartment in New York and she has a Range Rover by starting TikTok. So you never know where it will bring you. Hi. She was listening to my TED Talk.
Do you have any piece of advice?
Live, love.
Okay. Okay. Oh. So with that, we are done with my makeup. This took me way too long, I will not lie. I've been talking for like 30 minutes. Not all of this is gonna make it in the video, but I do hope that, number one, I made some sense. Doing my makeup and talking to a camera is not the easiest task in the world, believe it or not. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I, again, did my makeup for no reason, but I wanted to chat with you. I really hope everyone is doing well out there, and I hope that my advice was somewhat helpful in your life. And you never know, if you start posting on TikTok, maybe you will have a house in the Hamptons or outside of the Hamptons in a year or two or three. Will I have an actor boyfriend in a year? I don't know. Time will tell. Stay positive and maybe that'll happen for you too. I don't know. I will see you all very soon for another video. Just because I'm going on a trip, that does not mean the content is stopping. Absolutely not. I will still be posting every Sunday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I will see you all very soon for another video.